These are some steel cutting bandsaw blades, and I want to try them on my 20-inch bandsaw. Now the problem with this is these blades need to run much slower than I can get with just putting a motor on here. So I'm thinking of putting this pulley on the back of the motor and then powering that with another slower motor. I made this pulley many years ago when I was experimenting with building an apple grinder, and the problem is it's got a 1¼-inch hole. And so to fit on a 5/8-inch shaft, I need to replace these flanges, so I need to cut the old ones off because they're glued on. But even if I move the blade guide all the way into the housing, I still don't quite have enough room to get under it. So I think I'll just have to remove the table. And now I have a full 15 inches or 39 centimeters. I can move the blade guides down a little bit again. This wood screw locks the pulley in place. Not the most precise pulley, but it's running very slowly. And so far, this is just an experiment, and the saw is running nice and slow. Now, I don't want to scratch up the plywood table or my metal cover, so I'm making a temporary plywood cover. So, will it work? That is the question. Nope. It doesn't. It looks like when it stalls, this pulley is still turning, but the V-belt is slipping. So I need a bit more tension on here. Well, that belt is on quite tight now, so hopefully this will work. Man, that is super slow. Let's try some aluminum. Well, at least the blade is not getting warm. Man, that's just annoyingly slow. Let's try cutting something else. So I applied a little bit of oil to the blade because that always seems to help with metal cutting. So some of those chips coming off were definitely hot because they hurt when I hit my hand. But the blade is still cool because it's got all this way to go around to cool down before it cuts through again. That was 1-inch square steel, and the cut quality looks pretty decent. Well, it's not too bad in terms of steel getting stuck on the inner tube. Although rubber tires for a metal cutting bandsaw is definitely not ideal.
I also tried cutting some 2mm thick material, and this cut much faster. This part of the video is not sped up.
I just uncoiled this massive blade, but the problem is the teeth are facing the wrong way around because These massive horizontal cutting bandsaws always run counterclockwise, whereas vertical bandsaws tend to run clockwise, so I have to turn this blade inside out to get the teeth facing the right way. And before I try to flip it, I think I'll put the protective plastic back on the teeth. I've flipped one of these blades before, but I don't quite remember how, so let's see how it goes.
How does this go?
Ta-da! Yep, goes the right way around now. Okay, I'm kind of afraid of this. I might damage my bandsaw, but if I do, I'll just have to make some spare parts for it. Well, that cut a fair bit faster than with the other blade, and it's got an interesting sort of pattern on it from the teeth. It's a fairly clean cut, but not quite as clean as the cut I got from the 13 TPI blade. Alright, let's try another pop can. I also tried cutting some wood, but it just kept binding. But running at high speed, it worked just fine. So this bandsaw actually can be used to cut metal. But this crazy 3 TPI blade is really only suitable for very thick stock. What makes more sense is a blade like this. This one is 13 TPI and is closer to what you'd put in a portabandsaw. Now, if I wanted to optimize this saw for metal cutting, there's a few things I would change. I would put the thrust bearing to be against the blade like this, because there's an awful lot of pushing against here. I would also reduce the height here, because you're never going to be resawing a big chunk of metal like that. And that would make this guide post a lot stiffer, again, because there's a lot of force on here. The other things I'd change is there's really no need for rubber tires on there, and I would make the pulley that's behind it actually almost the size of the wheel here, just so it's easier to get more torque on there.